Hello, this is Jim. This is the Jim Ordinary channel, and we will be going through some simple weapon makings, or not too simple. We'll make a bit more advanced. We'll go through weapon combos and also effects, its computers and modules. So we will basically be going through how to make a bit more advanced weapons than the regular ones. So let's begin. I'm going to build a platform, and you understand what I mean by platform. Okay, so this is what I mean by a platform. Now we will be need to going into shop, because we will start to make a machine gun stuff. And for that you need two cannon computers. And, well, let's buy some more cannon barrels. On the way we're at it, we can buy some. Let's buy 10 of those. We'll just make a little shopping spree here. Okay, so now we got our guns. Let's start to spawn a cannon computer. And this will be our regular cannon computer. Then we will take and spawn. Let's go into advanced. Let's see here. Wrong. No. That's the one. Let's use spawn 5. Spawn 5. So this is our regular. And then we need to spawn the other cannon computer. The funny thing with these modules is that these won't shoot. It's 5 wide. So we can, just to prove that, we can place them another direction. It doesn't matter. Because these cannons, they are not firing cannons, but support cannons. Now we choose this. And wait, we can go in and you can see the difference. Whoops, no, I gone out. Okay. So we press T, get our weapons menu. And question is, which is which? Okay, so I drag it down, you see? This fire. Boom, boom. Like that fast. We go into build mode again. And now we choose this computer. And we connect up this support. Because these are not firing, these are support cannon parts. I know it sounds weird, but it's that how it works. And now, they're super fast, we got machine guns. But say we would want to do like this, that we would have a bit stronger cannons, but well, let's remove 4 blocks from the support and we go into the regular actual firing cannons. Oops. And then we add up these. Well, then we get a quite fast cannon. Because if we go into T weapons menu, you see here, we have that support, then we have effect. No, support. We have 42% support. Before we had 100%, that was the maximum speed. If you have equal amounts of blocks connected to each computer, the one that fires and the one that is support, then you get 100% of the effect. You can't get more than that. You also can disconnect them and connect them up like this. Inside the menu, if you would like to. So that's basically how to make a machine gun. So I will remove this and then we will be going through missile. Or wait, I want to show you how to make a would-be sniper cannon also. One sec, you see, this is the chart for all the modules that is in-game. This is another chart. that I found when I searched on the web. And here you can see it's much more logical, I like this better. And you can see the different stuff you can make when you connect them up. And I will be showing you how to make would-be sniper cannon, because that's a much, it's a quite good description of what it is. So, well, one needs the damage beam computer. Place that out, and then we have damage beam modules. We can just face them another way, so we remember that they're actually not firing. And then I can do that the other way now. Let's go into flight mode. We press T, weapons menu, and we drag the beam computer on the cannon computer. And now we got a sniper cannon. You see the reload time is slower, but it's more range and more damage. Anyhow, now we will be going through some missiles. Because this weapon is my favorite weapon. It's so easy to use, I'd really suggest you use this. It's awesome. First of all, let's spawn the missile computer. Like that. And then I usually connect them like this, but you can either way. And now. Now we got lock-on missiles. When you connect the damage beam to support this, you get lock-on. So let's find something to lock on. I probably don't want to lock on the shop. Wow, there is really nothing around here. Anyways, you can fire one shot at the shop without them caring. So let's. We need to have it in our. You can see the red ring is hovering around. We have lock on. Fire! Oops, you see, it's super fast. We shall not fire again. But it's super easy, you just lock it on a pirate ship or anything, and then it fires. It goes super fast. I'm not completely sure about this, but you see, now we have 100%. But you can have lesser percent. I'm not completely sure, but I do think they are a bit slower if you don't have so much support, because these are very fast. Because I had just a few one, and you still lock on if you have few DEAM modules, DEAM damage beam modules connected to your damage beam computer, but they are traveling slower. Let's do some other combos. Let's place four missiles there. Then we spawn another missile computer, and we have just four missiles down here as support. These won't be firing, so we connect them up. Get in the ship. Now we should zoom out, because now we have created heat-seeking swarmer missiles. Be warned, if you're flying with your friends and you fire this, it will just hit anything. This is something to use when you fly into a pirate's nest and you want to disabling many ships at the same time. Because I just fire them. And they like fly and they all hit the shop. Excellent. Well, this is the last time we will shoot the shop, because missiles are dangerous. So now let's spawn the cannon computer again. I like to make them another direction, so I remember that they're actually not firing. Like that. And then we take the missile, connect up to the cannon computer, so now the missiles have support from the cannons. And then, we got fast firing dumb missiles. It's a bit fun. I mean, it's like, yeah, diving in and firing lots of those. Then another thing you can do is that you can have this damage pulse computer. And then you place up like, yeah, we have 100% support. from that one. We go in 2 and we fire. You see the damage, not the damage, the power. The power went down. Because these missiles are like, I would call these torpedoes more. Space torpedoes. They're heavy, slow loading, and does huge amount of damage. If you're attacking a station, this is the weapon of choice. Actually, this is the weapons of choice when you're attacking a station. But this with explosive effects. Let's go to shop and be looking at some effects. Where are they now? General effects. And here is a piercing effect. Explosive effect, we want that. So let's buy 4 modules, so we have 100%. Because these work exactly the same way as supporting by cannons. Effects are just another cool thing. You know, punch through, stop effect, push effect, pull effect, iron effect, damage shields, overdrive, and overdrive. Anyways, let's spawn the explosion effect computer, like that. And hook up some of these. This is our main cannons, missiles. Hook the effect up also. When you go into flight mode, you can see here that we have the effect on, explosive effect. So these are basically large, huge, evil, explosive torpedoes. Look what we have here. We have a decayed station. I actually just noticed that these seem to be lock-on. So, maybe I have mistaken, because I actually didn't thought that the torpedoes were lock-on. But now I have lock-on, because I noticed, you can see. We choose another target and it will get confused. And then we will choose this, because... And then you see, we have lock-on. And then we will aim outside the lock-on zone to see. Wow, they're actually lock-on. I are wrong about. Okay, missiles with pulsars on have lock-on, and you can see they did 900 in damage, and that was only of 4 blocks. I mean, well, let's create a explosive shotgun cannon. We place out cannon barrels. And we will have 50% support by explosives. I can see now, because we didn't buy so many. And then we will have missiles on too. ...100% shotgun effects. Now it's hard to reach, we just go into here. And we drag the missile computer on and explosive computer on. Now we will have a shotgun cannon. You saw? Isn't that cool? Missile to a cannon makes a shotgun. It spreads out things, basically. Okay, lastly, we will go through how to make some damage beams in different fashions. So, these are damage beam modules. Place out 6 of those. And yeah, we don't have another damage beam computer with us. Plus, if we would connect another damage beam computer with as many blocks as support, we would get a long range pulse. Not pulse, beam. Long range beam. So we connect cannons and have it as support. We go in and here. See, we have fume small pulsars. They don't do much damage, but they are continuously firing small bursts. So I mean, that's cool. If we would connect up a pulse as backup or whatever, well, let's choose some damage pulse modules. Have as many of those. Now we need to go into T menu to link those up. Well, then we would get would be siege beam. You saw how much damage that did? It also took up all our energy. So, well, if you connect pulse, you basically make things heavy and stuff. If I would connect up in a missile computer, it would get lots of beams all over the place. So, well, that's basically how to use weapon combos and, weapon effects. I hope this tutorial helped, and, well, please like the video, comment if you want to comment anything, or if you don't want whatever. Anyways, have a good day. Jimodism out.